Put a beat on.
Straight raw, man.
You can't put a beat on?
Straight raw.
Put a beat on. I want to spit over a track.
You know what it is, man. It's Grind Season TV. It's your boy, Vis Swoops. And we got our boy in here, King Famous. And he put his squad on. What up, bro?
That's a fact, man. That's King Famous, man. Shout out to Grind Season TV.
I appreciate it, bro. I want you to do shout out and stuff to people.
I'm Mo.
Yo, I'm Enigmatic. What's good, y'all?
What's good, bro?
We got King Famous in here. He back on the scene. You've been low for a little while now. You ain't really give us too much.
That's a fact, bro. That's
but I see fact. You back. We got one of the drinks playing right now. That's all. You got a couple other tracks in work. But how did King Famous start his whole music career and all? How did you become King Famous?
I've been rapping since I was like 8 years old, honestly. Back home in Africa, so I got a couple of songs in my language and all that, so. Rapping, it's really been in my family. My uncle put me on, you know, we was writing music together and all that. So, man, when we moved to America, I stopped rapping for like a year. And then, you know, I got back on the drum because I like to write, you know. I used to write poetry and all that.
Yeah.
So, rapping, I've been rapping for a minute, man. That's a fact.
See, that's crazy. So, you said you're from Sierra Leone, right?
Yeah, Sierra Leone.
So, and a lot of people only know about the Diamonds Are Forever drink, but Kanye said they got the Sierra Leone version of that.
Right, that's a fact.
For hip hop to travel that far, like who was your influence coming up in Sierra Leone? Like what kind of artist was building to you?
My artist, man, my favorite artist coming up, man, my icon always been 50 Cent and Cassidy. You know what I mean? I like 50 Cent because I just feel like his lifestyle is real, you know what I mean?
He traveled a lot there too and do a lot of shows out that way.
That's a
one
fact,
of the few artists I know that do that. So.
Yeah, definitely one of my top artists, you know what I mean? So yeah, that's a fact.
I apologize, bro. I'm sitting in my room. I thought one of us was playing music. Seriously, but anyway, you said some 50 Cent and Cassidy was your influence. Anybody that influenced, how would you describe your style or your form of hip hop to other people?
My form of hip hop is just like storytelling, you know what I mean? You know, lifestyle, my life, you know what I mean? Struggle, you know, lyrical, you know what I mean? All that, so that's why Cassidy influenced me, because he lyrical, he raw with it, you know what I mean? He don't just rap about the same thing, he switch it up, you know what I mean? When he make his songs, he sound different, and when he freestyling, you know, he switching up his style, giving people what they want to hear, all that, you know what I mean? That's the type of music that's going to last, like 10, 15 years, you know what I mean? So. That's my type of time. Like,
so my question to you, because you know, you remember the mid-2000s, everybody was saying Wayne was the man, but then it was a big crowd saying, but Wayne can't out-rap Cass, though. How you feel about that one?
How I feel about that one?
If you had to pick, you picking Wayne or you picking Cass?
I think Wayne creativity level is crazy, but when it comes to mainstream music, you know what I mean? When it comes to like freestyling with Cassidy, I don't know, man. I think Cassidy got Wayne, you know what I mean?
I like both of them, and I was one of the dudes on the Cass side, so I can't even go against you.
Cassidy really grow with it, bro.
Yeah, I feel
Cassidy, V Dollars, shout out Philly, man. You already know.
Shout out to Philly.
I fuck with a lot of artists, man. That's a fact.
Yeah, I mean, Freak just dropped his album not too long ago, and it was fire, so
it's one of the albums
I feel this
year. Yeah, actually, I heard this nigga he lost the battle again.
Oh, what? $3? Oh, yeah, I heard about that too.
Yeah, this
man.
Man,
listen, Reed don't gotta do nothing. That one freestyle he did is so legendary.
I forgot. I think he bossed
it.
He bossed it. Matter of fact, he bossed it being here on the Summer Madness card.
Okay.
Facts.
Facts.
Shout out to all the battle rappers on the URL circuit. Shout out to the ones on site. Shout out to my boy Tom.
Shout out to my man Igma too, man. He a battle rapper.
Igma, we gonna get you. I'm gonna check some of your stuff up, man.
That's
worth
it. I just got a few things on there. Not too much.
So again, coming from Sierra Leone, whole different culture from American culture, but the one commonality that you had was hip hop.
Right.
And like, you say you was influenced by 50 and by Cass. we know Akon is the man over there.
That's a fact.
So what was Akon influence like when you over there? People calling him Black Panther right now. He coming out of cryptocurrencies, providing lights and everything. Like,
that's a fact. At the time back in my country, man, I ain't gonna lie, I ain't heard of Akon until I came to America, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, and that's a whole fact. His, I don't know where his music at was at level-wise, because international rappers, 50 Cent, was well-known internationally, so that's why, like, in the club was popping in my country, you know what I mean? But even 50 Cent, when I came to America, is when I really started listening to him and fucking with him, you know, his background, you know, I fuck with his music, his style, the way he carry himself, you know what I mean? That's a fact, so. Yeah, Akon didn't really influence me. I think what it is, it's like his style of music. You know, he's a singer. He real too, he tells his life story, but the background, because I'm a rapper and he's a singer, so that's why I wasn't really into
Akon. French?
French Montana? Oh, man. French Montana, I didn't really listen to French like that. Man. I ain't gonna lie.
French is my God. But you have new music coming out. Yeah. Like you said, you took your little hiatus. You want to explain your little hiatus to the people, like why you took some time to yourself to do what you had to do?
Honestly, it's a long story, man. I could go deep into it. I had my little rap group, Young Kings, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's how the name King Famous come into act, because my name was Young Famous, you know what I mean? And I had my group who was doing shows and all that. We opened for Ray Sherman. That was one of our top shows, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And after that, we just kind of fell off because of like personal reasons and all that.
Egos, you know? And all that. Whenever you got a group, it's going to be some kind of somebody's not feeling somebody.
That's a fact. And I had a mixtape on their computer and stuff. You know, I mean, was ready to drop my mixtape and then drop the group mixtape and all that. So whatever material I had with them, I just let them have it. You know what I mean? So I was quiet for a little minute, getting my money up. You know what I mean? And you're gonna hear a lot about my story in the mixtape that's coming up. It's been a long time coming, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, that's a fact. So, when that happened, the group kind of broke up, Young Kings. So, I took that King and put it in my name, you know what I mean? There's only one King left, and that's King Famous, you feel me? And that's what I represent myself, you know what I'm saying?
That's
fine.
Nah, that's fine. That's
OD dope. Yeah, and then it fit well too. I like the sound of it. People fucking with it and all that.
I mean, you shining like a king and shit. You might as well call you Pharaoh. Shining.
Yeah,
you feel me? I respect it. I mean, that's you. It's all that work. Gotta appreciate it. That's a sharp a little bit. And then you got people on the tape. You got Beanie on there. You got Wes.
Free
Beanie, man. Free Chizzy as well. You got Wes, you got LaFleur on there.
Yeah.
A couple of guys.
They see LaFleur, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They ain't ready for the rest of the material I got coming, though. A lot of material, man. And, like, as far as the features, I got more features. Like, the thing I was trying to do is I was trying to connect the city, you feel me?
Yeah.
Bring the city together, you know what I mean? So I'm trying to, my mixtape is just based upon, like, getting everybody involved, putting Rochester on the map, man. Know that we making noise, that we got a lot of talent in the city, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So yeah, I'm looking into doing more features with more artists, you know what I mean? So yeah, it's definitely gonna be fun, man.
Any producers from Rochester on there?
Any producing? Nah, I got my personal producer, Jack Oaks, you know what I mean? He make the beats and stuff. Nobody know him, he know, but that's what I'm saying. The talent, everything, you know, the process is low, we keeping it quiet. You feel me? When we come out, it's gonna make noise, that's a fact, you know what I mean?
Okay. Strategic planning and everything
that's
like
a
that.
That's a fact.
I definitely could appreciate that. And like you said, you've been sitting there perfecting your craft and working on things that you really wanted to do. That's dope. And then you say back with your magic here that's a bad. We want to talk a little bit about what got you in the battle rap.
Man, what got me in the battle rap? Cassidy.
The freeway battle.
Yes, Cassidy. And then I started getting into League Dollars, Arsenal, Meek. When he was rapping back then, you know.
No luck.
KRS-One, you know. A lot of they battles, you know, because they was going in like clubs and everything, you know, and battling, like just doing it on the block. Biggie, you know, they was doing it on the block and everything, you know. I was into that, but like, what really, really got me into like battling, it was like Nas, when him and Jay-Z was going at it, and they beef and everything. And then he did this one show, he was like, when I was 12, I went to hell from snuffing Jesus. Like, that shit was crazy. That shit was crazy. And Nas is my nigga, like,
I'm a whole fan. I'm a fan of both of them, but I tell people all the time. Shout out to my brother. We have this debate that who won over Jay, and I always say Jay won. But it's Ether, though. It's Ether.
Overall, yeah. When you say overall, yeah, that's
but
a fact.
I'm like a lot of people. They never listen to Blueprint 2. That song, when he responded after Ether, and he was really at Nas, but Nas did so much damage with Ether, people didn't even care to hear it.
Right. Yeah, that's but a fact. I
didn't really like Jay-Z, but I like hip-hop. I like lyrics. I think he really got at Nas with Super Ugly. Facts. Nas
was
super ugly.
Nas
won it with
home.
That shit was crazy.
But that's the one thing about that situation, because this dude was out here. I see you actually one of the very few guys that's cool with everybody. Do stuff. Because you know Rochester has this culture where if you're from a certain place, they don't like you.
Yeah.
They find a reason not to like you.
That's a fact.
And you do your thing. Yeah. But the guys don't like to keep it on wax no more.
Yeah,
it could go from somebody saying, oh, you look like this, or saying this about you, and then people shoot each other.
Right.
How do you stay out of the drama and everything like that? And move so, in the way that you move, have your movement still build without any kind of negativity. I mean, a little negativity, but nothing crazy.
Yeah, as far as negativity, you know what I'm saying? I don't do no negativity. I just do me, you know what I'm saying? I'm cool with everybody, you know what I mean? My music is one thing. As far as music, I ain't got no beef with nobody or none of that, you know what I mean? And as far as, like, keeping the negativity out of my life, bro, I just stay low, you know what I mean? I ain't out there, I'm humble, you know what I'm saying? Like you said, man, you ain't heard of me until you seen the music video, you know what I mean? I've been low, I keep it low, you feel me? So I stay out of it, man, you know what I'm saying? All that, it's a fact.
So what is your goal? What is your goal for after your tape drop or your goal within this year? Because you got the tape coming out. What else are you trying to push forward?
The goal is to just make noise, you know what I'm saying? Let people know that it is a fact. It's been a long time coming. It's been a really long time coming. I don't want to drop the project for you, you know what I'm saying? I got a lot of materials that I didn't even use because, you know, as time goes on,
music changes.
You know what I'm saying? You want to come with the style that the young generation is fucking with. So most of my music, I just put it aside, you know what I'm saying? And that's a fact, bro. So my goal is to just, like, when I drop the tape, you know what I'm saying, see where the numbers go, and a couple of songs on the tape, like 5-6 songs, it's like original, my beat, my lyrics, and all that. So I'm going to put some of that on iTunes, see how the streaming goes. And then right after that, I plan to drop the album. It's been a long time coming, you know what I'm saying, the album. And see where that goes, you know what I'm saying? Start doing shows after that, all that. Get back on doing shows, because that's one thing. You know, that's one thing you gotta do, let people know how you really person and all that, you know what I'm saying? That's a fact.
So, within that 2-year hiatus, was there anything that you missed about music? What would you say you missed the most? Was it the recording? Was it the performing?
I miss performing, you know what I'm saying? Performing was lit, you know what I'm saying? Because I feel like I connect with the crowd when I'm on stage. I feel like I'm at home, you know what I'm saying? You know, because rapping is my life, man, you know what I'm saying? I love rapping, you know what I mean? Always been into rapping, I always been like music, you know what I'm saying? I used to dance and all that, so hip hop, I've always been in the hip hop world, you know what I mean? So yeah, that's a fact, bro.
That's what's up. I mean, you're not gonna be one of them dudes getting a face tattoo, because you know, now everybody wanna get the face tattoos.
I'm home, man, I'm deep. You know what I'm saying? I'm from Africa, my background is different, you know what I'm saying? So US Africa, shout out my country, you know, big time.
I don't know, no, that's a fact. Knowing African culture, knowing cultures and how families are structured, your mom ain't having you just come home, face tattoos, no matter how old you get.
I'm a grown man, I do what I want, but just because of my background, what I learned, you know what I'm saying? I ain't saying I'm against tattoo, I'm thinking about getting a tattoo, you know what I'm saying? But I ain't gonna put it somewhere on my face where everybody can see it, you know what I mean? All that, nah, that's not my style, bro.
Roll up in court this whole time, he's at face tattoo. He's like, nah, son.
In the same way, it's just like the respect and the whole background.
Yeah, right? That's a fact.
That's
what I'm
like installed into you. It's like, you know, almost like what your mom teach you. It's like, yo.
Like, for example, I don't mean to cut you over that nigga the boot game. You know what I'm saying? Like, a couple years back, he had like one tattoo on his fist. Now you see that man, boy, he don't got no like skin or his whole face is full of tattoos, bro. That's different, you know what I'm saying?
Boom is weird. He's a weirdo, honestly. Like,
yeah, I think so too, bro. He's a weirdo, that's a fact.
And from just talking to you, I mean, I've heard only a couple of tracks that we've sent each other in our conversations and transportation before. And you don't seem like a person that just, you a clout chaser. You do stuff because you need people to validate you. Like, you come in like, hey, I'm cool and calm. Right. But you also got that confidence, like, whether I'm a pop music or not, I'm still going to be that jiggy swag you do. That's just the way I am.
That's a fact, bro. The way I see it, like I said, I've been rapping for a long time, you know what I mean? So as far as, like, chasing the clout, I just always felt like my lyrics is on a different level, you know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
And I'm proud of that, and I know that. Other people know that, and they tell me that, and I tell them that, you know what I'm saying? You gotta show respect where it's due, you know what I mean? So I've been rapping for a long time. You know, been doing this, been having mad tracks, you know what I mean? But now I'm coming out with it, and then the world don't go for me, you know what I'm saying?
Exactly, and that's how it's supposed to be, because that clout thing or chasing a phase of hip-hop, when it changes, are you gonna still be around when that fade, when that sound or whatever that wave dies? And that's the one thing y'all realize to be important, because
that's a fact.
Like we talked about Wayne earlier, Wayne just got out of his deal with Cash Money.
Right.
And that Carter IV, everybody like, yo, when Carter IV gonna drop? But they gotta understand that sound on the Carter IV probably won't fit now, because
right,
it's been how many years?
That's a whole fact. Yeah, I didn't even think about it like that, honestly. Yeah, that's a fact.
So it's things like that, but you seem to have your head on straight and you know what you want to do and how you want to maneuver. Do you have a team or anything like that along with you as well, or is it just... it's just you right now.
It's just me right now, man. But like I said, I collab with a lot of artists, you know what I'm saying? So I got, everybody on my team the way I see it, you know what I'm saying? I'm not against nobody, you know what I'm saying? I want everybody to flourish and shine and make things the best way they can, you know what I'm saying? So yeah, right now I'm just, I'm solo. I had a group, but that died out. So right now I'm just doing my thing as a solo artist, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
On my busy, you know what I mean?
Yeah, hey, you know what I mean? Busy. Camp, you got a camp name, something like that? Maybe a future record label in the future, something like that?
Yeah, honestly, I ain't even go on my group, man. Young Kings, it's just, I don't have nobody in it right now, you know what I'm saying? Okay. But yeah, hopefully in the future, that'll definitely be my label name, Young Kings. That's a fact. But right now, I'm just trying to build my platform and let people know that, you know, this is all me, you know what I'm saying? I did this for me, you know what I'm saying? That's a fact.
That's a fact. That's a fact. Like, I mean, I respect that group. I mean, you seem to have good people around you in your support group. Nobody in your head telling you, yo, you don't need this person, you better than that person.
Yeah, that's
the first thing. Now, my advice, I mean, you got that already. My advice to anybody watching this, trying to become an artist, anybody in your head telling you you are something before you get there, you need to just remove them away from you.
That's a fact.
Because they got some ulterior motive. They don't really want you to be great for you. They want you to be great so they can benefit and stuff like that.
Well, yeah, that's a fact. Well, you could ask all my people. Tell them suckers they can wait. Cause I'm paper chasing, busy trying to get my way back. Playing the court, but I be balling like a lace. Nigga, the other day I had this. It's been a long time coming. Cause I'm late court. I said I'm on my way. Where you want me to meet you at? I don't keep that energy. You know, as soon as I smell that bad energy, bro, you might not see me again, you feel me?
Exactly.
I don't got to be for nobody. I see you in public, you dab, you know what I mean? But you ain't going to be seeing us chilling again on a personal level if I don't fuck with you, you know what I'm saying? If I'm feeling that bad energy, that's a fact. So, yeah, all good people around me, man, you know what I mean?
I mean, anything else, because we've been covered a lot. And just what I feel like we've been talking for like hours now, and I got to begin to know you more. Hopefully, people can know you more.
Yeah.
Anything else you want to get in there, let people know? Pause, I say, and pause when we sound like Rochester. Pause, I mean, say anything else you want people to know about Young Famous or King Famous?
Yeah.
Young Kings team,
yeah.
King Famous.
King Famous, yeah, yeah.
Anything you want to know about you?
Man, all I want people to know is, man, you know what I'm saying? I'm a Sierra Leonean, shout out Africa, you know what I'm saying? Came all the way from my country. And you know how it is out there, I don't even know how to say, you know, struggle, poverty, you know what I'm saying? We pray for them every day. We just had a flood like not the end of the year, but, you know what I'm saying? Right in my country, it says, you know, right in my city, you know? So we pray for them. So
free towns, a lot of shit.
You don't want that. That's a fact, yeah.
Funny part about it is, as much as we know bad part, when I was in college, I studied African American studies. So in order to understand what happened in African America, you gotta go back I'm going through a lot of shit.
Right, that's a fact, bro.
A lot, especially with all that European people coming trying to take shit, and then they leaving them to fight each other and all that crazy shit. That shit fucked up.
Yeah, that's a fact. So yeah, like that, you know what I'm saying? So I just want people to know, you know, what I'm doing is real, you know what I'm saying? My lifestyle is real. I came from Africa, from the struggle, and that's what I'm trying to tell people. And to just come from Africa to America is a blessing. And, you know, to do this rapping thing, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, I'm tight, nice at it, you know, that's what I'm trying to push that. And, you know, my pops and this whole side of the family is still in Africa. So, you know what I'm saying? I got to do something, you know what I mean? And rap is all I know, you feel me? So, that's a fact, bro. I just want people to know that I'm coming.
You on your way. You on your way. You want anything. Also, vitamin water. Get that man his sponsor.
Shout out vitamin water.
Always drinking that shit.
Always drinking it. And it gotta be the yellow flavor. Maybe the yellow flavor.
I don't fuck with any other flavor, man. The other flavor is like, it tastes like it got too much sugar, you know? So that's why I fuck with this one. It tastes light and shit. It's just like water with a little flavor. Shout out vitamin water.
Sure.
Well,
you got anything you want to tell the people before we get up out of here?
Yeah, I don't say much though. I'm here supporting my brother right here from the same country. You know, wherever like he goes, if he makes success, you know, I'm with him. Always.
See, matter of fact, see, we over here giving these closing statements. How did y'all owe me?
Yeah, let's
get that in there before
me and him right here, my mom. And his mom been friends since they were like 6 years old, you know what I'm saying? So we've been knowing each other for a while, same country, same city. So we brothers, for real, you know what I mean? And my man right here, we met in college.
I
didn't even know he rapped. We met on some other shit. We was talking on some personal shit, you know what I mean? You know, so we was sitting one time, I was telling him that I got a concert. I'm opening for Ray Sherman. He's like, oh, you rap? And then we just sat there, and I think like 5 hours went by, we was just rapping, and back and forth.
Like, missed our classes.
Yeah, that's a whole fact. And then we just been tight ever since, bro. And I told him, like, I think he one of the nicest in the city, bro. If I could pick a top five right now, bro, he would be, you know, top three on that list, bro. That's a fact, bro. And I believe in what I say. He's a battle rapper. You know what I'm saying? We going to make noise, bro. We coming, bro.
Listen, on site. So I'm talking about boys, so yeah, on site, y'all need.
I know M-Way, I know all time. They just was at my own event. I did an event with B-Goon, shout out to B-Goon, Bozzy Still and everything, you know. Shout out M-Way, shout out Stupid, all that. Big Russ, all of them niggas, man. Shout out on site, man, word, man.
So y'all do know about the grand season basketball tournament coming up, right?
Last season basketball tournament. Oh, what's up, man? What's up?
First place team. We doing it. You don't got to play in the team, but you either got to coach or play.
Right.
We doing it Rucker style. Each rapper got their team. Eight people maximum.
Right. It's like a 3-on-3 or 5.
5-on-5.
5-on-5.
5-on-5 with 3 subs. We provide you with shirts or jerseys, you feel me? Yeah. It's gonna be a trophy as well, and all that. First place get $450 budget for a video.
Okay.
They get a beat. It was from Ness, but Ness, he had some other obligations, so he said he won't be able to give the beat.
Right.
But he'll work something out with whoever wins, so you're gonna hear from Ness. Have some pop connection with him after that.
Okay.
But the TC Beats is willing to work out.
TC, shout out TC.
TC is willing to work something out to get a beat in there as well. And the video get featured on the Grind Countdown, which is the other show that we do as the new dream of the week. So if y'all want to get in there, $250 to registration fee for the team.
Shout out to my nigga TC, though.
Listen, man, I'm going to post the link up. Anybody watching this, shout out sponsors, Educated Thug, Wayman's, and Black Wire Solutions. So if you need to get your phone fixed, go to Black Wire Solutions.
Got you already. Yeah,
we going to get it. It's going to be popping. You got free food for the kids, too. Right. So
that's
all
lit, man. We there. That's a fact.
All right. So your closing remarks, though. We got everything in there. Anything else you want to say?
Man, I'm just proud of Brody, man. Cool. Man, this my nigga, man. This is my nigga, man. We used to do damage at NCC. I know community college, I went to, not MCC though, but I went to community college. It was fun. Tell him about the trip here though, those songs I was playing. I sent you a couple. I mean, what I like about, I mean, it's not even just because you're my man, it's just music in general, bro. I like how every song different, you know?
Right.
And I was there when you made your old shit, so I know where you came from. I was there when this nigga moving back and forth through the studio trying to find a place and shit. I was there with this nigga. He was there with me rising, going up through the grind, battling and shit, doing different shit, going in mad different open mics and shit. Being skipping class in the hallway, me and this nigga rhyming. Niggas betting us again. Throwing up paper, we making niggas back down. Like, you was there for each other. So, like, I've been with my nigga. Like, even though we ain't talked, you know, through the years like that, I know I could all, when I did see this nigga on concert, it was always the same love. You feel me? So, I just want, I want Brody to keep doing and see the best. And we going to do the best together because that's how it always been. I just want Brody to do the best. That's it. Kill these niggas. That's it. Kill these niggas.
Kill these niggas. That's a fact.
And we going to end it on that note, man. This is Bronzian TV. It's your boy, Vince Swoops.
Yeah, that's a fact, man.
Boy, King Famous.
Bronzian. Shout out to Bronzian.
Facts. King Famous.
Shout out.
Bolo. The nigga.
Bolo.
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 My fault. Bolo.
Bottle, that's a fact. King Famous, man.
We out of here. Get on your Grizzly.
Get on your Grizzly. Yeah.